DJ Carlos is live on the promo show, man. Little man.
Yeah, what's happening?
How you doing, guy?
I'm shaded up, chilling, man. Birthday gang banging. You already know what it is.
Tell the listeners where you're actually born.
I'm born and raised in West Los Angeles, West LA, baby, all day. Yeah.
What was it like growing up there?
Growing up in West LA, man, it was real. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't like, you know, I was raised in, like, you know, the best of the best. You know, I grew up in, like, the hood. And, you know, it was a single parent, just me and my mom. And, you know, I mean, it was cool, though. It definitely taught me how to have swag and taught me about street life. It taught me about what I don't want to be a part of.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the gangbangers, all that. Like, I had a firsthand experience with all of that. And it's like, you know, I wanted to represent, you know, living like every day is my birthday.
Yeah.
So that's what I represent, you know what I'm saying? But I'm still from West LA and I still love my city. And you could tell by the swag, Dickies, everything. It's still West LA, baby.
Do you feel finally that New York are playing East Coast, like West Coast tracks? Because like back in the day, they wouldn't do it.
New York still doesn't play West Coast tracks.
They don't play your... Mm-mm. Are you being serious?
My records does not play on the East Coast, which I don't know why, because it plays in the clubs, but like a lot of radio stations don't play it. And it hurts my feelings because I love the East Coast.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I love going to New York. I love going to the East Coast. I got a lot of love for the East. And when I'm out there, the people show me love, but radio, they don't really play my records out on the East Coast. But in the West Coast, we got it on lock.
That's not good at all, man, for real. Nah, but they that's just...
I wish all that would stop, though, because I feel like good music should be played everywhere.
Wherever it is.
You know what I'm saying? Especially since 50 hopped on my record, I feel like the East Coast should have showed a little bit more love, you know, because I show love to the East Coast all the time.
Yeah.
You feel me? But it is what it is, though.
Well, most rappers on the West Coast are known for their gangster rap, but much with your style is completely different.
Exactly. I'm not a gangbanger.
No,
that's
real.
Why. I'm not a Blood or a Crip. I'm just, you know, I rap the birthday gang, and we live life like every day is our birthday. So we, honestly, man, all I do is laugh, joke, kid around, and have fun. You know what I'm saying? Just I'm young, man. I like being young, and I like representing the young people. And this is what we do.
When I listen to your tracks, you actually expressing yourself.
Yeah. You know, it's really like funny that you say that because, you know, like with Buzzin', you get a lot of the good. You know what I'm saying? Like I do a lot of like up tempo fun records. But at the same time, I'm not, you know, just in it for like the fun. I'm in it to express my emotions. And you know, I'm working on a project titled Freshman on Varsity, which is all about expressing like what's happening right now in my life and what's going on. And it's all about just expressing like my real emotions and putting it on paper. And I feel like, you know, I'm a big fan of Drake too, and Drake to me is the best at doing that. Like when I listen to Drake, I feel like he's talking about my life or talking about the regular, like, you know, artist in the industry's life.
Yeah.
And I respect that, and I want to do that, you know, for who I am, and like, you know, represent how I feel and what I'm going through. So I think that's the most important, man. Just keeping it real on records, that's what you need to do, man. So that's what I'm working on, a project, a really real project. So Freshman on Varsity, make sure you get that when it drops.
And you released your album 3 months ago. How's it doing?
Man's World is doing well. You know what I'm saying? Man's World was definitely just kind of something we had to like put out because Buzzin was so big. We had to like, you know, put together a record about, you know, about like, you know, just that feeling. You know, we wanted to sample and make it like a West Coast classic record, you know. But I feel like also we have to build a bigger foundation as well.
Yeah.
So, you know, while Man's World is out, I'm dropping a free EP, a free project, the Freshman Varsity project, to kind of let people know who I am before. Because a lot of people don't want to buy something without knowing what they're about to get.
Yeah.
So I'm putting out this project, and I think that after this project, like, everything is going to come full circle.
Tell us about the track, Text.
Text?
Yeah.
That's funny. Text is an old record. Like, me and Jason, like, when Jason came to the label, Jason was a, you know, just a cat from, you know, Florida. He was a writer at first. And, you know, we got together and wrote just records. And we wrote Text because I was just texting him. You know, like, I was on, you know, this is when I was talking to girls, just texting hella much. And he was like, you know, why you text so much? Because he, like, he'd rather talk on the phone. And then I said, yeah, I do. That's just some pimp, you know, that's just how I do it. And I explained it to him, and he was like, okay, let's make a record. Made a record and texted him. Yo, what's going on? This your boy, M-A-M-M-Man, and this right here is my song, Text, featuring Jason Derulo. Yeah.
She hit me up in the morning. She be texting when she stretching and yawning. She be like, good morning. I be like, good morning. While I'm making cereal, the milk I be pouring.
Moving on to the biggest track, I do believe, for the year, Buzzin'. Damn. Can I say the hookup came up with 50, man?
Well, really... Buzzin wasn't, you know, it didn't have 50 on it at first.
Yeah, the original, that's right.
Yeah, the original one is just with me.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was a record I made in the studio one day when I was just like, you know what, stuff ain't working out how I want it to work out, I'm going to just not care about what the label asked me to do. I'm going to do what I want to do. Mm-hmm. And Buzzing, you know, came. You know what I'm saying? And I made that with all the homies in the studio. We was just talking about West LA, playing video games. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if you hear it, I'm talking about Madden 2K. Like, everything. It's just, that's how, that was what was going on in the studio. And, you know, it came out and everybody loved it. You know, I thought it was going to be a mixtape record, personally. Everybody loved it. And then it was playing on LA radio because me and my management team leaked it. You know, the label, and nobody was really ready, you know what I'm saying? But we leaked it and was like, you know what? We feel this record's big, so we going to do it ourselves. Put it out, and LA started playing it. It started blowing up in LA, and out of nowhere, 50 hop on. And we was just like, what? Like, what are you talking about? Somebody told my manager, said 50's on it. Like, you're lying. So 2 weeks later, it was like just a rumor at first. 2 weeks later, it dropped on his website with no prior warning or anything. And it just kind of like blew up. Yo, what's going on? This is the West LA Young, the birthday boy himself. And this right here is Buzzy. Yeah. They come around like honey, 'cause I'm fly like a bee. Oh, yeah. Man, I got them all buzzing, 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 buzzing.
We had a massive track back in the day, Mark Morris and Return of the Mac.
Yeah.
And then you came out with this track. Wow, how did that happen, man?
Honestly, man, like, every song has its own story. The Return of the Mac is an old record.
Of course.
I laid that, like, 2 years ago. Yeah. And I laid it after, you know Nipsey Hussle? He had it at first. And, you know, he didn't like it. He didn't think it was good for his brand. You know what I'm saying? Which makes sense, because Nipsey's more of a gangster. This is kind of like,
yeah.
So I was like, yo, I want it. And everybody was like, well, all right, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, man, forget y'all. I'm going to go rap to it myself. Did it. And 2 years later, after Buzzing, they was like, yo, do you still have that Return of the Mac? I'm like, yeah, man. Y'all want it now? They was like, yeah. So we put it in. Like, you know, everybody played it. We edited it up and put Snoop on it.
Yeah.
Which was just like a big deal to me, too. So after that, it was like, yo, let's go with it. So Return of the Mac.
On the album, what's this featuring?
We have my homeboy Ty Dolla $ign, who is also a rising star in Los Angeles. He's like the new Nate Dogg, killing hooks. Every new record in LA, he's killing the hooks. And we have Nappy Boys, T-Pain.
Yeah, for real.
Shout out to T-Pain, because we have one of my favorite records on the album. That's Get It Girl, and that's my new single.
Is that your new single?
Yeah, this is the new single, Get It Girl, featuring T-Pain himself. Check it out, Man's World. Yeah.
So on the album, is there only 10 tracks?
Yeah. That's another reason why I'm putting out the project, the free EP.
Okay.
Because, you know, I feel like fans deserve me. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially with my first look, you guys need more to really get to know me. You can't really get it, man. You know what I'm saying? So I got a really cool set.
So do record labels allow you to like do your album at the same time do a mixtape? Are you allowed to do that?
I don't know. Yeah. I just do what I want to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just honestly, man, I'm an artist.
Yeah,
and I feel like as an artist, sometimes you have to do what you want to do and not ask.
No,
and not do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's really for my fans. So I don't really like, you know, not that I don't care. I love my label. Shout out to David Massey and Mercury. But I have to do what I have to do.
Yeah,
and I have to please my fans. And I have to please the birthday gang. And you guys want more music, so I'm giving you more music.
Well, thanks for coming on to the promo show, man.
Thank you for having me, man.
No problem. Anything else you want to say to the UK fans? And we're worldwide as well.
Live every day like it's your birthday. And that's all I really want you guys to know. This is the birthday gang. Man, general, we here. We living every day like it's our birthday. All my fans do the same. And we having fun. We trying to change the world. We trying to really make it a way better place. So, you know, that's all I really want y'all to do. And everybody in school, make sure you keep getting good grades. And don't do drugs.
Take care. Have a good one, man.
You too, bro.
Respect, man. Everybody know my name. Call me Manning, that's T-Pain. Swaggin' heavy in the gap.